Hello, everyone, and welcome to Hot Numbers.
Hello.
Hello, Teacher Pendo.
Now, who can remember what we learned about last week?
Teacher Pendo, I was on holiday. Please, can you remind me?
Well, we looked at the units used to measure mass.
So what units do we use to measure mass?
Well, who can help Marara out? Yes, Simeone?
Kilograms and grams.
Very good. And can anyone remember how many grams make a kilogram? Yes, Buluma?
1,000 grams.
Very good.
Now, Teacher Pendo.
Yes, Marara.
Mass seems to be very easy. I think I can go on holiday more often.
Okay, Marara. Now, let's see whether you've mastered it. Now, how much do you weigh, Marara?
Now, Teacher Pendo, that's a very personal question.
While you were on holiday, I asked everyone to work out how much they weighed so that we could practice conversion.
Oh, I see. Oh, I'm sorry, Teacher Pendo. I am 72 and a half kilograms.
Okay, so how much do you weigh in grams?
Wait, just give me a minute. A thousand. Yes, 1,000 grams is equal to 1 kilogram. Then, to change my weight into grams, I'll need to multiply 72.5 with 1,000. Let me see. Oh, Teacher Pendo.
Yes, Mara.
I weigh 72,500 grams.
Well done, Marara. Now, that is absolutely correct. Now, today we are still looking at units of mass, and we are going to solve problems dealing with grams and kilograms.
Teacher Pendo, I really don't enjoy solving problems.
Come on, Marara. It's not so bad. You need to know how to solve problems. It is a very important life skill. Now, my first problem reads as follows. Mike wants to bake a cake and puts the following ingredients in a bowl. 100 grams of butter, 200 grams of sugar, and 0.5 kilogram of flour. Now, altogether, how much do his ingredients weigh? Yes, Kienge?
800 grams.
Very good, 800 grams. Now let's show the working on the board. Now first of all, we have to make sure that we're using the same units. So how many grams are there in 0.5 kilogram of flour? Yes?
500 grams.
500 grams, well done. So we will write 500 grams here. And then we are going to add the 100 grams of butter and the 200 grams of sugar. So we are adding. So how many grams do we have in total? Yes, Kienge?
800 grams.
Very good. 800 grams. Very good. You see, Marara, it's quite straightforward.
Yes, Teacher Pendo, but I think I have another problem for us to solve.
Really? Let's give it a try.
Well, if Muthoni weighed 34 kilograms and 200 grams, Tom weighed 46 kilograms, 900 grams. Now, how much do they weigh all together?
That's a very good question, Marara. Let's put our thinking caps on and let's solve this together. So you said, just repeat that again, Marara.
Muthoni weighs 34 kilograms and 200 grams.
200 grams.
And Tom weighed 46 kilograms.
46 kilograms.
And 900 grams.
900 grams. Very good. So because we are trying to find how much they weigh altogether, we are going to add. So, who would like to give this a try? What do we do first? Yes, Awino?
First, we add the grams.
First, we add the grams. So what does that give us? Yes, Awino?
200 grams plus 900 grams is 1,100 grams. That is 1 kilogram and 100 grams.
Very good. So we are going to write, and then we are going to carry one here. So what's our next step? Yes, Simeone?
You add 1 mm-hmm. plus 34 and 46.
And what does that give us? Yes, Buluma?
81 kilograms.
81.
So what will our final answer be? Yes, Awino?
81 kilograms, 100 grams.
Very good. 81 kilograms, 100 grams, which can also be written as 81.1 kilograms or 81,100 grams. Now, we're going to solve another problem, and this time we are going to subtract. Omolo has a sack of maize weighing 89 kilograms, 400 grams. He goes with it to the market and manages to sell 46 kilograms, 850 grams. How much has he got left in the bag? Let me just write down the sum first. 89 kilograms, 400 grams. And he manages to sell 46 kilograms, 850 grams. Okay, so we are going to subtract. So how do we go about this? Yes, Kienge?
We will need to subtract 46 kilograms, 850 grams from 89 kilograms, 400 grams to know how much is left in the bag.
Correct. Now, before we go about the sum, we will find that 850 grams cannot be subtracted from 400 grams. So what do we do, Marara?
I think we'll need to borrow 1,000 grams from 89 kilograms.
Okay.
So 1,400 grams, mm-hmm. take away 850 grams, mm-hmm. that should be 550 grams.
Very good. 550 grams. Very good. Now, what do we do next? What do we do next? You remember we borrowed 1 from 89, so now we have 88 minus 46. So what is our answer? Yes, Nasaka?
42 kilograms.
42 kilograms. Very good. 42 kilograms. So what is our final answer? Yes, Awino?
42 kilograms, 550 grams.
Well done. Now, which we also write as 42.55 kilograms, or we can write as 42,550 grams.
Now, Teacher Pendo.
Yes, Marara.
Are kilograms and grams the only units for measuring mass?
Well, that's a very good question, Marara. Now, as well as grams and kilograms, we also use tons for weighing heavy objects like cars.
Aha! That is so easy.
Okay, Marara, so how many kilograms make a ton?
A million?
Not quite, Marara. 1,000 kilograms make 1 ton.
Ah, I get it.
Great work, everyone. Well, that's all we have for today's Hot Numbers, but be sure to join us next time.
Oh, I can't wait, Teacher Pendo. Now, you see, I'm really getting good at maths now. Maybe I'll even become a maths teacher when I grow up.
Well, that's interesting to know. Well, I'm pleased that you're progressing so well.